When I was a kid, I always wanted to know why. I was that annoying child that sat there and said, "Why is the sky blue? Why does popcorn pop?" And my mom enjoyed it for a while until she just was so annoyed with me. "Go ask your teachers." And then I would do it to my teachers, and they were like, "Go read a book." And then I started reading books. But I was never fully satisfied with the answers because whenever they gave me an answer, I wanted to know more. I automatically thought that I was going to go to college. That's the natural progression of a person for their education. So when I was in 10th grade, I asked my mom about my college fund so I can start looking at what colleges I wanted to apply to. And she looked at me and said, "What college fund?" And I laughed and thought she was joking, and "I'm serious." "Oh, so apparently I needed to figure out a way to go to college without having the financial backup." So I went and talked to my guidance counselor, and we discussed different scholarship possibilities for me to be able to go to a really nice college. And I was able to. I went to the University of Florida with 100% scholarship based upon my grades and my scores from exams. And I thrived there. So I've never actually had to get a loan to take classes. I've always had scholarships, but I needed to get help with financially was living, my food, my rent. And so I've always held two jobs throughout school, taking a full course load. And during all that time, I actually was able to graduate in 3 years. Taking classes, I realized I really liked science. I took a variety of different science courses. And even in the classes, I would stay after asking the professors, "Why is that? Why is this?" And their answers were never completely fulfilling to me. I took genetics as a class when I was an undergrad, and I really liked it. And it really helped me in understanding a lot of the bigger questions I had. And so I really wanted to understand, ultimately in science, how we go from a sperm and an egg, which is a one cell, and you combine them and get such diversity in the world. I've always loved nature and animals, but we all start from the same thing. We all have DNA and RNA. How does that build onto itself to form such different aspects, a plant versus an animal versus a fungus? And so I started with internships as an undergrad and then moved into a job between my undergrad and my PhD, where I was working in a molecular phylogeny, looking in birds and working mostly with DNA and RNA, and then built my love for genetics from there. I just remember going to work every day happy. I wanted to learn more. I was never upset having to be there, even though science has its ups and downs, but the highs were so much better than any low that you can have. And it was an adrenaline rush to get the results that you finally work so hard to get for different experiments. And I knew that this was the place I wanted to be and wanted to stay with. So right now I'm working on corneal regeneration. So I'm specifically looking at stem cells in the eye. So the cornea is actually the upper part of your eye. So it's the outer layer. It kind of looks like what your contact would look like. And in certain people that have either medical conditions or a physical problem like a burn, are unable to regenerate the cells that are necessary for their eye. So the outer corneal layer is full of epithelial cells, and every time you blink, you lose a layer of cells. You're blinking, there they go, there goes another one. And your eye has to constantly be regenerating those epithelial cells. And there's a stem cell population in your eye around the edge of your cornea, so that around the iris, so the colored part of your eye, right around the iris, is a stem cell population. And in that stem cell population, that is where the cells are made that regenerate any damage that occurs to your corneas. But there are some people that have a genetic defect and are unable to regenerate those cells properly. So ultimately, what we're trying to do is work with a specific genetic defect called aniridia, and it's based upon the loss of one allele of PAX6, which is a gene used in eye development and regeneration of the cornea. What we're trying to do is take stem cells from a patient that has this disorder, culturing them, add the correct gene into their own cells, and then put them back into the patient's eyes so that over time they're able to regenerate their own corneas if there is wounding